Hello students, welcome back to the biology class. So in the last class, we carried on with the 13th chapter, that is the photosynthesis in the higher plants, and we did about the dark reaction pathway, and the pathway's name was C4 pathway, which involves double carbon dioxide fixation. We learned in the class that this double carbon dioxide fixation is basically to increase the concentration of carbon dioxide inside those cells which perform C3 cycle, so that instead of C3 cycle they never start photorespiration. We learned that there are 18 angiospermic families, where three monocot families and 15 dicot families. Total 1500 species are able to perform C4 pathway, and we did some of the examples also. We understood that this pathway evolved in the tropical, subtropical area where the salinity is high, aridity is more, and temperature is also high. We understood that how these plants have evolved, even their anatomy also, and the special name of this anatomy is called as the Krenz anatomy, where rings of the photosynthetic cells are visible around the vascular tissue. And we learned that there are two types of photosynthetic cells in these plants, the bundle sheath cells and the mesophyll cells. We learned that the mesophyll cell in these plants is not divisible into palisade and spongy, though in the C3 plants it is generally divisible into palisade and spongy mesophyll cells. So we understood in the last class that the bundle sheath cells are those cells which surrounds the vascular bundle. We learned that they are found in every plant, but in the C4 plants they also carry chlorophyll inside them. So a normal plant which does not perform C4 pathway, their bundle sheath cells will be devoid, or they will not carry the chlorophyll inside them. We learned that how these two type of cells are connected with the help of plasmodesmata to maintain the symplastic continuity, and we understood that there is dimorphic chloroplast in the Krenz anatomy, granule type and the agranule type. We learned in the last class that the bundle sheath cells carry larger chloroplast which do not carry grana, and the mesophyll cells carry smaller chloroplast which carry grana. Just remember that the bundle sheath cells are those which surrounds the vascular tissue, and mesophyll cells are those which are next to the epidermis, or which is in direct contact with the stomata. So the bundle sheath cells perform cyclic photophosphorylation, and they perform C3 cycle. And because they perform cyclic photophosphorylation, there is no splitting of water, so there is no oxygen evolution, and they have Rubisco enzyme in abundance. In the case of the mesophyll cell, they perform C4 cycle along with the bundle sheath cell, and then there is oxygen released in these cells because they have photolysis of water. Reason is they perform non-cyclic photophosphorylation, and instead of Rubisco enzyme they carry peptidase enzyme. We learned in the last class that the first carbon dioxide fixation in these plants occur in mesophyll cell, followed by the second carbon dioxide fixation occurs inside the bundle sheath cell. We learned the importance of these plants, that they are able to survive in high temperature because of these two enzymes, and these enzymes are able to function at the high temperature. We learned that they are more efficient to function under full summer sun. We learned that how C3 plants, they feel saturation only at the 70% of the full light. And then we understood that the C4 plants are able to tolerate high salt concentration in their environment or in the soil because they carry organic acids. Which acids are these? C4 acids. That means the aspartic acid, the malic acid, as well as the oxaloacetic acid. And we learned that the rate of carbon dioxide assimilation is double when compared with the C3 plants in the C4 plants. And they transpire less. And because they transpire less, we learned that they conserve water. And they even continue to perform photosynthesis with their closed stomata. And you remember C3 plants, when they close their stomata, photosynthesis stops. And there is hardly any loss of photosynthetic activity because C2 cycle is absent in the case of the C4 plant. C2 cycle is equal to photorespiration. We'll be learning about that hopefully today. we learned that the C4 cycle starts with the initial fixation in the mesophyll cell, where the first acceptor is the PEP, phosphoenol pyruvic acid, in the presence of PEPCO or PEPCase enzyme, to form oxaloacetic acid, which is transformed into either malic acid or aspartic acid, and then it is shifted into the bundle sheath cell, where it again liberates the carbon dioxide for the C3 cycle to be carried out, and the resultant pyruvic acid as a byproduct will go back into the mesophyll cell. We learned one important point here, that the phosphoglyceric acid will be shifted to the mesophyll cell and then change into the PGAL, and then after PGAL it will be shifted back to the bundle sheath cell, where it converts into the hexose sugar. Because of these activity, oxygen is not liberated, there is no photorespiration in these plants. We learned that there is requirement of regeneration of PEP. So the pyruvic acid formed in the bundle sheath cell will go back into the mesophyll cells, and with the help of dikinase enzyme, it converts into PEP. So this is the reason why there are two extra ATPs required. That means total 5 ATPs and 2 NADPH are required in this process.